I shall call him Squishy, and he shall be mine, and he shall be my Squishy. Hey everybody, it's Chugga Conroy! Welcome back to more Splatoon! Last time, we had a close encounter with the guest kind. I don't know where I was really going with that, but we had a guest, Miss Sayonella, who helped us show off both of the carbon rollers. This time, we have returned to Octo Valley, and we're going to be here continuing on with our adventure. I know Captain Cuttlefish's life was put in mortal danger, and we just kind of ignored it to go off and play in turf wars. But, you know, those bad guys, they never kill their hostages right away, right? Yeah, I'm sure he'll be fine. So we're going to ride the ink line once again. Or ink rail, actually. Ink line would be like skiing, right? That is actually a brand, and they do make skiing equipment. Gonna ride this over. Thank God for a larger ink tank, otherwise I wouldn't have been able to... Never mind! Ride yet another ink rail, and that takes us to... quite a boppin' place. We got lots of power... like structures ahead of us. Seems like this whole place is just a giant power transformer. It doesn't appear operational, however. Thank you very, very much. I take great pride in destroying civilization as you know it. This is gonna take us down below to yet, man, they really like their ink rails. Let's open that with a, can you not open these with bombs? Like, that's pretty covered. I think that's about as covered as it's gonna get. Oh, it, I didn't actually get to see what level it was in because I wasn't expecting it to work. Crap, what do we got? Hey, yo, what's crackin', playa? We are going into some amiibo challenge here today. I hope that this challenge is, well, challenging, because that was not the case when we went with the Inkling Boy challenges last time. So we're going into Tumbling Splatforms, the Tentacles of Fate. And if you think I'm reading that title overly dramatic, look at the size of those things! These are the tentacles of fate. And they are attached to... absolutely nothing. I was actually kind of hoping that they would be attached to like a giant octopus below us or something like that. So the main challenge that we have ahead of us are these rotating platforms, or rotating splatforms, if you will. We're gonna have to navigate these with nothing but a roller and some splat bombs by our side, and we gotta be the hammer! Gonna bring that ink down on top of their heads. I kinda hit right there. Oh, not bad, okay. And you taste the hammer. Now this stage, the song that is playing in the background is, okay. I've been kinda waiting to talk about this. The soundtrack to Splatoon, it's very good, and it's very, unique. It's kind of a fun way of saying that it's weird and not like any other soundtrack you've ever heard. But it still manages to be good. I'll let you have a listen. I heard some whistling Dixie in there, some doorbells, and I think somebody insulting my mother. Yeah. It's a really weird soundtrack, and it's not just this song either. This is just a song that I wanted to point it out with, because, like, Splatak. One of the normal battle themes that was around from the beginning, the song that a lot of people think is the main theme of Splatoon or associate the game with the most, that song, the guitar solo in that song isn't actually a guitar solo. It's just a guy going, except it sounds a lot more ear-pleasing than whatever crap I just fed you, but it's the best I can do, okay? I'm a little on the tone-deaf side, as people who are not very neurotypical tend to be. Okay, we're gonna... bring that down, get even more power eggs, rolling in these things. Then again, I think I would just end up with like fish egg jelly if I were to do that. Is that a thing? Because if so, that's gross. All right, here we go. There's more tentacles of fate. This one looks like it's a locker that you could get shoved into. Maybe that's what those windows are for. They just decided to make a comfortable living abode out of it. Okay, I'm gonna hide. Oh, you only fire off one shot. Peanuts, take you down. That is what I say to you. You, and I'm gonna stay on this because I am greedy and I must take all of the unborn fish that I can. Wait, wait, what? They're all stuck in my ink and I wasn't even trying. Oh my god, that was funny. They're supposed to walk in circles around this area, but Without even trying, I put ink right in their pathway and they all got stuck in it. I apologize for all 8 of your shoes that I gunkified. Okay. No. I should have stayed in squid form. I would have had it. Always hurts when that happens. It is a little bit time consuming to get back up to where you were, because you are having to use the roller to just cover everything in ink again, and it's not exactly the fastest at doing that, but yeah, climbing walls with nothing but a roller by your side is a little bit awkward, and it usually spells certain death in verses, because people can just shoot you while you're trying to climb up. Okay, well, I guess this is a good opportunity to show that that crate in the middle right there is where your sunken scroll would be if you were playing in Octo Valley, as I typically like to show. And what am I worried about? I can easily climb back up to this wall. Looked uninkable at first, so I got a little worried, though, but nah, we got our one fish egg! Well worth the effort! I mean it, really, I do. Like, having one additional fish egg is better than the OCD ticks that would give me for having not collected it and not ever actually knowing. I prefer to know, though I'm sure a lot of people have just stopped popping balloons altogether because after the 12th or so time that a balloon gave them one egg, they felt cheated and never went back to it. You gonna go ahead and make the exchange right here. Go upward. This reminds me of that zipper, like, carnival ride that you always saw, like, at state fairs and stuff like that. I don't know. Maybe it was a local thing. I don't really know if it was. But we will take our derpy-looking plush and go onward.
Aw, he's so adorable. I just got pat him on the head.
What? Yeah, remember who he's dinner with? Meaning is him, or oh, you'll.
You're holding that upside down.
Oh! Agent 1 of the new Squid Beak Splatoon reporting in!
Agent 2 also reporting in. We got an SOS from Captain Cuttlefish.
Are you Agent 3? Don't worry, we're your new support team.
Yep, we're taking over for the cap'n. Well, we're gonna try.
But we gotta hurry, or the cap'n is as good as sushi.
Let's roll, Agent 3.
What does it say this time?
Is the big fluffy one providing shelter for the little fishy one? Or is the little fishy one manipulating the big fluffy one? We may never know. I was gonna say we may never need know, but then I realized how stupid that sounds. Maybe I am getting a little bit better at catching myself. Then again, I kind of have to do it more than one time to have a track record of that. Okay.
We changed the tentacles of fate.
It's like the tentacles were his toes or something like that.
So let's activate this ink rail.
And I guess activate this ink rail to, oh. So there's multiple things down here. I was just showing how you get back, yeah.
Should you activate this geyser, it'll bring you back up to where we were. And also,
I'm not gonna activate all these. I wanna leave at least a little exploration for the future times that we visit this part of Octo Valley, cause we are all done with Octo Valley for now.
We soar off to Inkopolis Plaza so that we may see something entirely new that Splatoon has to, Miiverse is awesome today. Wow, okay. I was already thinking about pointing out just how spot on Miiverse is this time around, but this is what, the 5th pose that had me thinking that? It pops up now of all times? Okay, you betcha I'll give you attention. I'll give you a yeah. However, you can stay over there. You gotta earn that hug a little bit harder than that. Make another good drawing. Maybe it'll come to you. Maybe. Okay. So, this next thing isn't exactly something that you can do in the game. It's more a cool thing that happened. Alright. So, if I may go to my equipment menu. You might have noticed that there's been a hat that I've been wearing lately. I wasn't counting on this thing coming in handy as much as it was, but this is the Squid Girl hat. In addition to it, there's also the Squid Girl tunic and the Squid Girl shoes. This is a reference to an anime and manga called, well, Squid Girl. If you've never seen it before, think Invader Zim, except starring a little girl who has all the powers of a squid. No, I'm really not making that up. That is the best comparison I could make about it. It's about a girl who came from the ocean, is basically part squid, and with her squid-like abilities, is seeking out revenge on the human race for polluting the ocean, but It goes about as well as you would expect with her having the abilities of a squid. It's very funny. I haven't seen a lot of it myself. It's something that I've noticed getting a little bit more popular lately, but when I first played using this hat, there were some people saying, hey, is that the squid girl that I think it is? And yeah, it is. It's kind of funny though, because when you think about it, she exists in this universe, and the manga recently ended, so she actually did get what she wanted in the end. Human civilization fell, and squids rule the world now. As for the gear itself, though, I was gonna be negative, but now that I look at it, my rolls on my Squid Girl gear is better than any Squid Girl gear has any right to be. You would think that they would have given it terrible abilities just to kind of make fun of her, which I guess opening Gambit's not useful on too many things, and you wouldn't really want to run main swim speed up on shoes because there's two wonderful abilities on shoes already, but this isn't bad. I would not doubt if this could be made to work with at least some weapon out there. But that's about it. It's a pretty quick topic, and rightfully so, because we're gonna go off to ranked mode with the weapon of the day. It's been a while since I almost said kick the bucket. That's, wow, bad analogy. Tri-slosher, yes. It's been a while since we've seen a slosher, so I'll recap. Sloshers operate on different rules from other weapons. Ink travels in an upward arc, the ink gains power as it travels and falls, and higher ground is good. The main attributes that separate the Tri-Slosher is that it launches three shots in a fan pattern at once instead of just one long one. It's lighter, and it can launch attacks even more frequently than the original. The wider area of attack shortens range when compared to the original Slosher, and it does slightly less damage. Due to how much ink the Tri-Slosher throws around and how fast it can throw, mobility is great. It's admittedly not the most different main weapon from its brother, but to me personally, it's just so much fun. Its sub-weapon is Disruptor. Excellent sub-weapon right away. This is your effective range, since hitting an enemy with a Disruptor is the backbone to playing the set well. It only uses 50% of the ink tank, so use it and pursue the enemy if they try to get away after it's used. One thing to watch out for is that you need to hit somebody twice at close range in order to beat them, whereas a roller only needs to hit you over the head once. Hitting them with a Disruptor does not cause their attack to come out any slower than it already does, plus when one roller flick is enough to kill you, the ink usage penalty doesn't mean a whole lot to them. So when using a Disruptor on a roller, you'll want to use the movement penalty to your advantage more than anything else. If a stage has grates, use these to your advantage against a shooter. Shooters have a very difficult time aiming directly below them, but you can easily throw ink up at them for a quick two-hit kill, and Disruptors also hit through walls and floors. The wide fan of ink and the large hitbox of a Disruptor allows for multi-kills if the Disruptor can hit a group. Special weapon is Bubbler. Also use this! It's a panic button, but it's also a pressuring tool. It's a lifeline to those missed Disruptor throws. It complements the weapon in many ways and turns so many situations around. Remember that a bubbler is a free reload, so you might as well throw a Disruptor or two before you use it. With such a short-range weapon, remember that there is no shame in using your bubbler for a free super jump after your goal is accomplished with it. This kit is excellent at tower control. Gets its bubbler all the time because it can throw ink around all over the place. Movement and enemy positions are very predictable in tower control, so you'll know where to throw those Disruptors and get the most out of them. And just all around, it can stand on the tower with teammates, support them nicely, and ride into victory. Somebody once told me that the world is going to roll me. No. Somebody once told me that they consider the Tri-Slosher a spiritual successor to how rollers were in the early days of Splatoon before they received a bunch of nerfs. Between the wide hitbox, reasonably fast, reliable kills, and the Disruptor and Bubbler combo to make up for the fact that it has to hit twice instead of just once, I can't say that I disagree with that. As somebody who played the crack-on splat roller a lot back in the day, I see it here, and it was a weapon that I transitioned into using very well. It seems like all of the art-related weapons always have Nouveau for their alternate kits, and that's no exception here with the Tri-Slosher Nouveau. I want to visit the Louvre so badly. Same stats, but with light special depletion, and this set is meant for more tactical play. Its sub-weapon is Seeker. Been through this before. Use it to pressure from a distance, send them down narrow hallways to delay enemy movement. Alternatively, swim behind the trail of ink that it makes to set yourself up for a quick kill. Echo Locator is the special here. Instant reload, works as support, works in pressuring. A great thing to do is to always launch a Seeker before using an Echo Locator, because it's a free reload and Seekers are very expensive. You might as well launch one willy-nilly even if you're not sure if an enemy's hiding nearby. Can't hurt you. Overall, I'm not feeling the nouveau all that much. It does have some interesting rare stuff on it, like that Seeker, but I just think the vanilla covers its combat weaknesses a lot nicer. Look. Look at this. Just... It sounded like a great idea to have a few practice games before going into it for real, because, you know, we're going into rank today. Sounded great. And then I go to pick up my reward from Judd. And you can just barely see him on the other side of that text box. That speech bubble above him is orange. This means I am not getting my cash reward because I don't have the long, skinny arms that I have at the beginning of any Octovalley mission. Nope. Can't reach my arm over there. Can't wait 2 more seconds to go watch Inkopolis News. The thing is, my cash reward isn't even that much. I wasn't even up to the so hot rank, but it hurts. It's the principle of the matter that there was free money over there on the ground waiting for me to go pick it up. But no, I can't go get it. Instead, I have to go watch the news because it's apparently the frickin' law. That's a nice monopoly you got there. Map rotation time! There's virtually nothing you could say to cheer me up at this point. Let's see. Regular battle stages. Walleye Warehouse. Well, I don't get to play it. In the remote corner of a dimly lit warehouse, two brave Inklings prepare to meet their destined... Battling! They're battling, aren't they? This game is a dork! I've already decided that I'm going into ranked for the day, and what are the Turf Wars maps? A, my favorite map, and B, the only map we haven't seen yet. What maps do I get to play? Let me guess. Moray Towers? Okay, Black Belly Skate Park for a second. Watch me, supposed to zig ollie, brah. Oh, you'll bust something, all right. Kelp, okay. So humid in here. Battling makes me super sweaty. Yeah, I need a cold shower just thinking about it. I'm not going to make a comment about it, okay? I'm not going to go there. Could've. Not a shoulda. Not a, maybe a woulda, but let's just go in. This game is kicking me while I'm down today. It's so tempting to just go into Turf Wars, play my favorite map, have a jolly good time, and even though I don't really care for the other map much, finally go to sleep easy at night knowing that we've seen all the maps and I don't have to worry about one not getting shown, but I feel very strongly about playing the Tri-Slosher in Tower Control because that is what I main in that mode and I'd love to show it off. This is my equipment spread. This is what I usually go with when playing in Tower Control. I like comeback and quick respawn in tandem with each other. Comeback will make it so that you have higher stats within the first 20 seconds of respawning, so like an opening gambit, but a little shorter, and at the beginning of each, I almost said stock though, but this is not that competitive Nintendo game. Also going with a little bit of special charge up, a little bit. Ink recovery up will also be nice because the attacks are a little bit ink hungry. I have a little bit of that in my head as well to make 3 total subs of it. Pretty good synergy there. And then, this is your bread and butter of playing anything that's going to throw disruptors and get quick kills and that kind of thing. Stealth jump. That combined with comeback giving me higher stats, quick respawn getting me into the battle quicker, it's an excellent combination. And on top of that, just being able to super jump to the tower anytime I want whenever I have my bubbler, I think it's gonna work out quite nicely and we're gonna have a fun time of it, so let's go in. You know what the best part of this is? I am 1 knockout victory away from hitting level 50. I might actually get it today and have it right here forever and ever. Oh, the joys of gaming with a capture card. Okay, our team is looking like... Yeah, alright. And their team, they got a Tri-Slosher on their team as well. They also have a Luna Blaster. Get used to seeing those in Tower Control if you have not already. Seriously, if you've yet to see Luna Blasters in Tower Control, I don't know what you're doing wrong. Or what you're doing right, as it might be, because I am very jealous of you. Trying to go up to the side. Ooh, I just did not. Wait, that disruptor didn't hit? What? Okay. I'm a little bit confused by that. I might as well stealth jump. In Tower Control, you just gotta keep the pressure on the other team, gotta keep the objective going. Might as well super jump whenever you have the opportunity. Always good. Just gonna hang back a little bit right here. They got a brush on the tower. Brushes don't do too well fighting on the tower because of that spire in the middle. It can be a little tough for rollers as well, but I've always noticed brushes have a particularly hard time of it, at least when I'm playing and whenever I see people play, because it totally cancels one of your hitboxes. This is bad. I almost had my bubbler. Oh boy. Gonna hang back, gonna throw my disruptors a little bit. That is another thing you're gonna want to do in this set. It seems like everything I'm saying could be described as the bread and butter of this set. In fact, I almost said it right there. It was kind of awkward. Taking the tower again. Okay, just waiting for you, waiting to see what they're gonna do. Maybe what I should do, actually. I'm gonna go up this way. I'm gonna see if I can maybe get around. Oh, no, he's there. There's not an inflatable thing right there, so it's not as easy to be sneaky in that part of the map, unfortunately. But I generally like to do that where I just try to be sneaky, get behind enemy lines, attack them from behind where they're not going to see me coming. Just kind of play ninja while they're too busy focusing on the tower. I like doing that. I know somebody's here. I just saw them moving. Are they trying to out ninja me right at a time like this? Yeah, he's going this way. Okay, so we're going to do that. Going to stop laying low. Got to take some action. He's going up there. Down there. Man, this guy is on the move. It's the other slosher, too. Okay, they're down, but not by my hands. Oh, boy. Get rid of you. The Luna Blaster's there. I'm just being very wishy-washy this time around. I don't really know what it is I'm trying to accomplish. Let's get on the tower. Let's support my team. Let's go ahead and bubble her and fall off the tower right as soon as I do it. We are all, oh my gosh, we are all in the same place. That was a beautiful time to bubble her. Might have been wishy-washy there, but I think I made up for it quite nicely. Let's get our special. Oh, boy. Wow. We took the lead very nicely, and I'm going to super jump, super jump, super jump, super jump. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Go, 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 go. Just so long as I can beat on that tower for a second, it's easily worth it. Come on. Come on. Come on. Going to throw down my disruptor as soon as I land. Get you tagged. You are down. That is exactly what I like to see. That's not what I like to see, though. Respect on playing the Barry Splattershot Pro, though. I like that weapon a lot. Gonna super jump once again. I'm in a good position. I can just throw ink from up on top of this, spire in the middle. Not really the tower, you know, even though the tower does kind of spawn on it, so it's like a tower on a tower, and there's a yo dog in there somewhere. I don't know. I was never good at saying whatever is said in that order. It's like, I don't know, I always get, like, circles run around me whenever other people do it because they string it together so poetically compared to what I could do. All right. Try to get my bubbler built up again. Looks like they have the roughly the same idea. I'm going to go around this way because it doesn't really look like they're protecting it. Oh, nope. We got a brush right here. Throw up over and gone. You still okay. Sure. I don't know how those attacks I was throwing up over the wall weren't working, but if you say so, game. Sure. Good time for that to come in. I'm gonna hop back on the tower. Whoa! At least I interrupted his bomb rush. That's good, right? We could still lose this. It's still anybody's game. They got bubblers. They got a bomb. They have Luna Blaster. They have everything that I don't like to say that they have. How typical. Barely got you. At least there's nobody on the tower now but us. Keep super jumping. I know that this is a bit of a weird strategy where you just keep blindly super jumping to places. It doesn't always work if they have a sniper that's watching the skies and knowing where you're gonna land. That is definitely a way that this can be countered. And some people do see the strategy as cheap, but I did want to show it off at least once, and I think that this is a decent weapon to do it with. Might not be as good as him, the Luna Blaster, but hey, it is still a strategy that I like. I don't think we're gonna get that knockout victory here today. Possibly not even get... Oh boy, this could go, no, 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 I see it coming, no, 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 you are not, you are not, you are not, you are not, most definitely not, yes, oh man, oh, that was a nerve-wracking end, I thought for sure they had us, oh my gosh, twirl that bucket on your index finger, even though it's not actually on your finger. If I freeze frame it, it's twirling around on that empty space in the middle. But hey, I'm that cool with it. I can defy the laws of physics. Well. I'm hopping rooms. Because it's either I win the next match or I don't get level 50 right here. To make a long story short. Got the same map and we didn't even survive to the 1 minute mark, so nothing for me, and it wasn't even a match that I would have shown anyway. At least I'm just back to square one, but hey, at least we get a chance to show off the kelp. What a wonderful note to reach the level cap on. Only me. Okay, well, that wasn't much of a game. We'll go on to the kelp dome. Just wow. Yeah. Just wow. Kelp dome! Maybe you can bring me out of this funk and you can actually leave me with a higher rank than what I started with here today. We got the Luna Blaster on our side. They get... they have three blasters. Why? it really is as bad as it seems. Movement is so predictable in tower control. People get on the tower, you know when they're there, and if you just launch a blast, it's so easy to get your 1-8 kill compared to other situations. There's a reason why you see it run all the time, and why the other team always has all of them, and why you don't. It's because this game hates you. Don't pretend like it's not. I thought it was far enough away. You have the shortest range. Seriously. Super jumping near the tower, maybe? Possibly? Kinda? It counted. Cool. Oh boy. He was in his bomb rush, wasn't he? Yep. Should've seen it. So much back and forth in this game. It's exactly what I like to see, except for losing the lead, but it's okay. It's okay. We'll come back. I need to get out there in the middle. There's no two ways about it. They're gaining points on us. I gotta do something right here and now. So you know what? Hear my battle cry! I has a bucket. And I got that, oh man. Just gonna go on a killing spree with my bucket. I'm giving you that booyah. And, wow, that was... Darn, maybe all blasters are not evil. That guy really saved me right there. Right as that bubbler was wearing off, he did that. Well, it's my turn to return the favor. Oh boy, going in. Get two of us on the tower. Booyah. We're booyahing back and forth. We've taken the lead. Need to get away. And I can hit you through the grates. I don't even know what happened there. It was just such a... Wow, it was actually the one I was trying to hit. That's kind of funny. Again. Or maybe not. Or maybe so. What is going on the bottom screen? It was like playing the super jump animation over and over again. Were they just all dying that fast, I guess? Wow. Nobody super jumped over to me in time, did they? No, they didn't. Keep on that pressure. Just keep at it. 59 points, fairly solid lead. They are going to get a little distance on us right now. Man, this is just... I know I've said before the tower control has what I consider to be the most aggressive and mean community out there, and if you want a serious challenge, I recommend playing tower control the most. But just wow, this is... Every second somebody is done. What? Okay, it took me a second to process what situation could have possibly made bombs rain down on me that fast. And the only thing I can think of is that both of their Luna Blaster Neos got their bomb rush at the exact same time and were throwing bombs in the exact same direction, causing them to rain down as quickly as they did. There we go. That is the outranging of Luna Blasters that I think is oh so beautiful. Now we can take the tower. I am tagged with Echolocator, but that's okay. Just want to try. Nope, I'm getting out of there. I am not sticking around to find out what happens next. I need to get my bubbler up. Maybe we can get a knockout if we oh so can stay there. You are right down below me. Gonna hit you. I helped a little bit, right? I maybe got one of those hits in. Okay, need my disruptors to go off. You are creating a really nice window for me to enter through. Do that. Gonna go on there. Gonna get you. Gonna score us a few more precious points. That wore off a lot faster than I thought it would. That was really bad. Oh boy. The blaster's not down. The blaster is not down. Now they're down. Or the other blaster can show up right on the scene. This is... If you've ever wanted to see tower control at its purest, you got all the pieces here. Blasters, everyone playing blasters, everyone having quick respawn, everyone having stealth jump. At least I assume everyone does. I haven't been watching their abilities too much, though, but they've been kind of coming out of every orifice too much for them to not be playing that. Great out of context. Oh, I saw it coming, and I swam up anyway. I had no one to blame but myself for that last one. I think we more or less got this. They'd have to overcome a pretty sizable distance to be able to still take it. They got only 25 seconds to do it in. I think we're okay. I think we're gonna be fine. You, maybe we took the tower again. Saw you over there. Saw you, don't think I didn't. Boom, boom, gotcha, 2-hit kill. And yeah, I'm pretty sure that was a haunt right there. Oh. Didn't matter. I did what I needed to do. Kept them off of there. I rode the tower a good distance, got off my bubbler a few times. I might not have been MVP of this match, but I'm at least happy that I accomplished all that I did. There's my physically impossible twirl. 6 kills, 10 death. Oof. Looked like I covered a lot of turf compared to the others, though. I wish it showed you the turf exactly as it is, but hey, what are you gonna do? Maybe we can pretend that that was the triumphant victory that I got to level 50 on. I can't believe that. I hit the level cap for the very first time on any of my save files with a survived 1 minute bonus on a knockout loss in tower control. At least it's realistic for how this game typically is. Let's go to the Inkopolis Plaza once again and see what Judd has for us. Maybe he has something rather special to commemorate this. Also, that drawing is awesome. Wow! So, you reach level 50! Take this rare item I found recently! Oh. I've seen that cap around, and I don't know how I thought this, but I always thought that was an amiibo reward. I purposely didn't go and look to see what the rewards for leveling up were. Also, terrific. It's kind of cool to see that, because as a kid, I always saw the pun perfect, but I always misread it as perific, so it kind of hits close to home for me that I see that there. Damage up, it's Cuddle Gear, so it's neutral in what it gives you for its abilities. It's kind of cool. We will go over up all the level rewards at a later point. I'm getting very convoluted. Mew, your vibe is toasty. Here's a little bonus of 1,000 or 100 coins. You only wish you were getting 1,000. Also, my excitement wore off about as quickly as a real cat's. Meow. The Kraken special weapon turns you into a powerful giant squid. It can swim through any surface, even if it's covered by enemy ink. And if you press X, you'll jump to launch a nasty melee attack. It can even deflect incoming enemy attacks, though they'll push you back. You can't attack normally as a Kraken, though, so think before you use it. Turn you into a giant squid that the evil mastermind can leave the hero in the clutches of for him to inevitably escape from once the special wears off. Anyway, that's all for now. Not my absolute best performance with the Tri-Slosher I've ever had, but I think I did all right. Hopefully I showed you why I like it so much in a good way. Next time on Splatoon, we're gonna be looking at a long-range weapon that I'm personally a very big fan of in Splat Zones. See you guys then. I guess you could say that was inconvenient.